Now we want to test the transaction we created in the previous steps. To do so, we'll have GeneXus build the application, create the database, and do everything necessary to get the programs ready to be run and tested. This test cycle that developers undertake before the application is ready is called prototyping. The full version of GeneXus allows prototyping an application locally. That is to say, the programs and the database will be hosted on our network servers, and also in a cloud that is available to GeneXus users. In addition, we can prototype in any of the programming languages supported. On the other hand, the trial version only allows prototyping in the cloud and in C# language. We can see it here by opening the properties window and confirming that we can only prototype in the cloud. We'll do it right now by pressing the function key F5. Because it's the first run, we're asked to log in with our GeneXus username, also known as GX Technical Username. If we don't have one yet, we're offered to create one. Once we log in, GeneXus starts working. In the end, it displays a report called Impact Analysis. In this report, GeneXus examines the impact caused by the new definitions made in the knowledge base. Also, it indicates which additions or structural changes need to be made to the database. If we examine the report, we can see that a new table called Customer will be created. Also, that this table structure will have the following attributes. As we can see, GeneXus will also create an index by customer ID automatically. We will explain this concept later on. Since we agreed to have this table created with this definition in the database, we click on the Create button. So, GeneXus starts to create the necessary programs to create the database, which didn't exist, and the customer table with this structure in the database. Next, GeneXus executes those programs. And the database is created. Next, GeneXus generates other programs, that is to say, all the necessary lines of code in the selected programming language, so that our application does what we want, which in this case is to enter customer details. Also, we're informed if the result was successful or if there were any errors or warnings. Here we can see the application running. The default browser opens a web page. And here is a link labeled Customer to run the transaction that we've created. We right-click on the link and choose to open it in another tab. Here we have a page that allows us to add, change, and delete customers. We enter the details of our first customer. This customer will be identified with number 1. His name is John. His last name is Smith. He lives on 5th Avenue. His phone number is 1111. And his email address is jsmith@hotmail.com. We click on Confirm. And a message is displayed to inform us that the data has been successfully added. Meanwhile, the form is cleared and ready for us to enter another customer. Let's add the second customer. We identify her with number 2. Her name is Susan. Her last name is Brown. Her address is on 7th Avenue. Her phone number is 2222. And her email address is sbrown@gmail.com. We click on Confirm. And once again, a message is displayed to inform us that the data has been successfully added. To look for John's details, we enter his customer number, 1, and press the Tab key. we can see that John's full details are displayed, and that from here, we could change some information, like his phone number. Also, we could even delete customer John from the customer records using the delete button. We can also use these buttons in the upper section to browse customers by going to the next, or the previous one, the first one, or the last one. In addition, we can look for a specific customer using this window. This window was automatically created by GeneXus, and it corresponds to this object. Note that if we change the screen size, the controls are adjusted to the space available. What does this mean? GeneXus generates responsive web applications, or sensitive applications, which offer optimum viewing, good navigation, and excellent use of screen space. This is achieved with design features that allow viewing all the information in the screen using the functions provided by GeneXus to this end. These functions allow us to show different layouts depending on the screen size of the device. Now that we've seen everything that was automatically generated by GeneXus using the customer transaction that we've created, let's go back to the development environment.